Unfortunately, most of these resources are either semi-public or not very public. So information that is paid by our taxes, supposed to be free available, is not given to us. And it's very important to get it back. It is so because otherwise you cannot look for information at all. You can only search for things you already know. So you can look for things like name of the company or the name of the person. But what if you don't know either of that? You would like to look at the sector. You would like to look at the specific region or type of a business and figure out all the links that are coming from that. You have a few cases that were fantastic in recent years when the Panama Register was scraped legally because it was public, and then new interface was created for that database that gave fantastic overview of all the offshore businesses and so on. Another case that we learned about was the case from the Netherlands when a group of young hackers a few years ago took the data and they built a new web interface, much better than the one built by the institution that spent, you know, thousands of euros, and they did it over three nights, much better. But that opened a totally new spectrum of information and knowledge for activists, advocacy groups, and those who work on specific issues to learn how the businesses are functioning. Any obfuscation, any hiding of information makes investigation and understanding of problems very difficult or completely impossible. And that obviously means that if you don't have transparency, then you have corruption,